I know you've assembled a furniture, but that doesn't mean that you can build an entire wall. Little learning is a dangerous thing. Shivani, when will you understand this? Oh, hi people, welcome to my channel. I was just talking to my friend and, you know, she just watched a YouTube video on how to assemble a furniture and now she thinks she can be an architect. She can be a pro in all these stuff. And this is what we all do. We all tend to overestimate our abilities. We all know a little about things and we tend to overestimate our knowledge about certain things. And that's what Alexander Pope said in one of his most famous work, Essay on Criticism, that little learning is a dangerous thing. This is one of the most famous and most quoted maxims. And we have so many other maxims by Alexander Pope. In this video, we are going to study Alexander Pope and some of his important works from NET point of view. So now let's talk about Mr. Alexander Pope. Alexander Pope was born in a Catholic family, as you can guess from his last name, Pope. Anybody with the last name Pope will definitely be a Catholic. So he was a follower of Catholicism. He had suffered from this disease called Pott's disease. For those of you who don't know, I would like to tell you that Pott's disease is a form of tuberculosis. So nowadays we have TB. At that time they used to call it Pott's disease. And due to this Pott's disease, he suffered from breathing problem and hunchback throughout his lifetime. He was also very short-heighted. He did not grow more than 4 feet and 6 inches. So really short. And he was really upset about these things, that he was short-heighted and he suffered from this disease. Due to which he decided that he would not go to school because people will mock at him. So he decided that he would enroll himself in his self-school and will study on his own. So he started reading classical works, especially Homer and Virgil. Homer was a Greek classical writer, whereas Virgil is a Roman classical writer. So he used to read those works by these prominent writers. And, you know, he became so fascinated that almost all his work shows the influence of Homer and Virgil. And almost all his work shows his love for classical text. He was writing in a period which is called neoclassical or Enlightenment period. I would like to first explain what neoclassical actually means. Neoclassical has come from these two terms, neo and classical. So neo means new, classical means classical text, classical works of those writers who were writing in the Greek and the Roman period. So neoclassical basically means that renewal of those writers. When there was a period in British history from 1700 to 1800 when all the prominent writers were actually reading the classical text and they were appreciating the writing style, their form and structure, and they started imitating them. So that is what gave it a name, neoclassical, new classical. So writing the classical text in a new way. Okay, so that is what neoclassical period is all about. And Alexander Pope was writing during this period. It was also a time of scientific development. I would rather say it was a time of scientific revolution. There were so many great scientists who were coming up and giving their own theories. We have Newton who was there at that time. And he gave his own theories. So this was a period of scientific development. And people started to believe that the world can be known through sense, through logic, through reason. So they denounced superstition and they focused on skepticism. So skepticism, imperialism, these were the dominant things that were during that period. And under this background, Alexander Pope was writing. So you will find almost all his work talking about how reason and logic is important and how through reason and logic you can actually know the world. The first important work by Pope is Pastorals. Pastorals is a series of 4 short poems and it is based on Virgil's work. So we find how Virgil influenced Alexander Pope, that even Alexander Pope's first work was an influence by Virgil. Also, for those of you who don't know, I would like to tell you that the work was written in heroic couplet, and heroic couplet is basically rhyming couplet with iambic pentameter. And if you are wondering what iambic pentameter is all about, then you must go and watch my video on rhythm and meter, in which I've clarified how iambic pentameter is formed, how it differs from trochaic hexameter, and how all these meter and rhythm influence a set of poetry. So that was about pastorals. The second important work by Alexander Pope is his translation of Homer. And this was a question in July 2016 in the UGC NET paper, wherein he asked that who among the following writer translated Homer? And there were so many options, out of which Alexander Pope was the right answer. So you must remember that Alexander Pope translated Homer's famous work, Iliad and Odyssey. Now, Iliad and Odyssey are like magnum opus and they are really, really huge. And it took him 6 years to translate them. But then 6 years did not go in vain, because this translation made him very famous and he became financially successful. Also, due to his translation, he became so famous among the literary circle in London that he became close friends with Joseph Edison and Richard Steele. He also formed a club known as Cribbers Club with Jonathan Swift, John Gay and John Arbuthnot. There are so many other important literary movement going in the Enlightenment period and also following Romantics and Victorian. You can get a list of all the important literary movements that you should read if you are studying for UGC NET on my website www.arpitakarwa.com. We cover each and every literary movement and the name of those group members in my online course. So if you wish, you can join my online course. The details are given in the description box below. But coming back to what we were talking about on his translation of Homer, we find one very, very important critical statement given by Richard Bentley on his translation of Homer, wherein he mocked Pope and said that it's a pretty poem, Mr. Pope, but you must not call it Homer. And Pope was so offended by the statement, and in the New Catholic Encyclopedia, it has been written that no other poet in the literary history made the number of enemies that Pope made. So Pope actually made so many enemies because he used to criticize all those people in his work. People get so offended that, you know, they were envious of Pope, they were jealous of Pope, and they used to give critical statements about Pope's work. The next important work by Alexander Pope is his edition of Shakespeare. Yes guys, he actually edited Shakespeare as well. So he has done so much work on Homer, on Virgil, and now it's time for the great William Shakespeare. So he has edited his work, he has regularized Shakespeare's meter and also rewrote his verse. And while he was writing and editing Shakespeare's work, he found that there were about 1560 lines which were so bad, which were excessively bad, and he thought that Shakespeare could have never written it. So he excluded those lines from his edition of Shakespeare, and this angered a critic called Lewis Theobald. Lewis Theobald wrote a pamphlet called Shakespeare Restored, in which he actually criticized Alexander Pope's edition of Shakespeare and said that, you know, Pope has pointed out so many flaws in Shakespeare which are not so true. And, you know, when he was listening to the criticism by Lewis Theobald and there was Richard Bentley criticizing Pope's work, he got so angry that Alexander Pope decided that now he's going to write essays and pieces wherein he'll be criticizing all these writers who have mocked him. And then started the journey wherein he wrote Epistle to Dr. Arbuthnot. Epistle to Dr. Arbuthnot is a satire which he wrote for his very close friend called John Arbuthnot, who was a physician. John Arbuthnot is the same person with whom he started Scribbers Club. So I've just mentioned about Scribbers Club, which had members like Jonathan Swift, John Gray, and then we had John Arbuthnot. So these people were a member of Scribbers Club, and John Arbuthnot was suffering from a disease and he was on his deathbed. And at that time, Alexander Pope wrote Epistle to Dr. Arbuthnot for his friend John Arbuthnot. And in this work, entire work, it has been said that this work is directly autobiographical, and it opens with a very, very famous line called "Shut, shut the door, John, dear John, fatigued, I said." And this was a question which was asked so many times in the NET exam. So you must remember the opening lines of Epistle to Dr. Arbuthnot. The next important work by Alexander Pope is Essay on Man. Essay on Man was written by Alexander Pope with a motive in mind, and the motive was to vindicate the ways of gods to men. And you can see how it connects to John Milton's Paradise Lost, because Paradise Lost was also written with a similar motive. This work also talks about the great chain of being, which is a very, very, very important concept given by Alexander Pope. And he says that how everything is connected to this great chain of being. I talk about Essay on Man, Essay on Criticism, Rape of Locke in detail in my online course, because these are certain works which are very, very important from NET point of view. There have been questions repeatedly asked from these works. So we cover the summary and all the important points of these works in detail in my online audio course. You can get the details on my website www.arpitakarwa.com. Also, you will find a list of all the important writers that you should not skip if you are preparing for UGC NET English Literature. We have a list of 700 writers divided into 10 modules, which are very important from NET point of view. We cover all those writers in detail in my audio online course. So you can get the details on my website. You can have a list of all the writers, and you can also find all the previous year papers with solved answers in my website. So you can just start preparing for UGC NET in a revolutionary way. Before we end, I would like to tell you about one very important work by Alexander Pope, which is Dunciad. Dunciad is a satire, and it is divided into 4 books. You must remember the number of books all these works are divided into, which appears in UGC NET exam several times, because we find that, you know, these people keep on asking us about a certain work and in how many acts that work is, or in how many books that work is. So you must remember the number of books that a work comprises of. So when you're talking about Dunciad, you must remember that this work, Dunciad, was written by Alexander Pope in order to criticize hack writers. Hack writers, for those of you who don't know, I would like to tell you that these are the people who write for money. So they would write about anything if they are getting money, and they would flatter people who are very wealthy so that when they write a good piece about them, they will give them money. So Alexander Pope criticized all those people. Also, one of the most famous criticism that he gave in this work was on Colley Cibber. Colley Cibber was another critic who criticized Pope's work, and Pope got so angry that he made him a hero of Dunciad. And in this work, Dunciad, he says that Colley Cibber is the king of dullness. So Colley Cibber, according to Pope, is the person who is bringing dullness into the world, who is bringing darkness into the world. We have references of coming from Greek mythology, Hades, we have Lethe River, which is actually the river of forgetfulness. So all these references are coming up in this work, which is very important. So let's end this video, but before that I would like to tell you that we are running a GoNet quiz on all the social media platforms. The links are given in the description box below. You can join me on the social media platform so that you can keep yourself updated about the questions that are asked in NET exam. Also, before you go, do subscribe to my channel, because I post videos every Saturday and every Sunday to help UGC NET English aspirants to prepare for UGC NET exam. If you like this video, do give it a big fat thumbs up and share it with other NET aspirants. Till the time we meet next, bye-bye, happy learning, and keep loving literature.